Welcome back, boys and girls, to Colorado's number one bass fishing channel. Yes, I do live in Kansas now, but I'm officially ranked number five in Kansas.
I just looked that up, and there's like 66 bass fishing channels in Kansas, so that's not right.
Okay, I'm officially ranked 67th. And I'm trying to do a thing here.
What's that?
The fishing graphs.
Good, because you need all the help you can get.
I just don't understand why everybody's so rude to me. It's just uncalled for.
On a pimp gang with my pinky ring. Lot of gang, lot of bzzz in the icy chain. While you claim that you rich, that's a false claim. I be straight to the whip, no baggage claim. Whole lot of styles, can't even pronounce the name. You ain't got no style, see you on my Instagram. I be rocking it like it's fresh out the pen. Only when I'm taking pics, I'm the middleman. Walk talking like a boss, I just lift a hand. 3 million cash, call me Rain Man. Money like a shower, that's my rain dance. And we all in black, like it's gangland. Say the wrong words, you be hangman. Why me stick to your like a spray tan? Mister, what kind of car you in? In the city, love my name. Gotta say it. She can get a taste. She can get a taste. What a say? It's all the same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste. Let you get a taste. Do you love a taste? Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me. A lot of girls like me, wanna fight me. Get your check like check Nike. Me not icy, that's unlikely. And she gon' s*** me like a Pisces. Chains on the neck for the whole team. And I feel like Gucci with the ice cream. And my b*** want the Fenty, not the Maybelline. I'm the black JB, the way these b*** green. Make these b*** green. Pretty little thing.
If you've been watching this channel for any, if you've seen half of a video, you know I do not know what I'm talking about. But here's the thing, we're gonna try and install this. I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do it. I don't even know how I'm going to do it. I tried watching a couple of videos. They weren't really that helpful to me, but then again, I'm not that bright. So, but I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna do it. This was all ordered for me by a friend out in Colorado, one of the better tournament anglers out there in Colorado. So I believe I have everything that I need. I actually did not order this myself. That's how much I do not know about this. So, but I'm going to start with this perspective mode mount. And I think that's what I want to start with. You have an S and a P side. So for salt and pepper. So you have to decide whether you like salt more or whether or not you like pepper more. Okay, so I'm being told that S stands for starboard and P stands for port. So sorry about that. And it's going to go on my starboard side. How do I know that starboard is on the right side? The way that I remember it, this is today's pro tip. Today's pro tip to know that starboard means right side. Is that there's more R's in starboard for right. That's how I always have remembered it. Also, same thing for red. Red on right. So that's how you should know which way a boat's facing. Anyway, pro tip of the day right there. What R stands for. Putting these brackets on, they have little indications up, right? So it's gonna go up the trolling motor shaft, around the shaft like this, and then this is going to allow it to go into perspective mode by sticking off. And the reason why it has the two different sides is the angle, when it's up here on the trolling motor, is the angle to get past the head of the trolling motor. In other words, you don't want the image shooting straight down on the trolling motor. It should be kicked off just a little bit. 8 degrees. It's the only thing I learned from watching the Garmin video. you can't make this stuff up. Step one is to apply a sticker. So we're just gonna throw that away and wing it. So another point is, if you happen to have a Garmin Force, I can't speak for an old Trex or anything else, but the Force has a groove over here, and you're supposed to align that with either the starboard or the port, with which way the propeller faces. So my propeller faces the starboard side, so I'm going to align it with the S. That notch is going to run through the middle of that when I put it on like that.
Yeah, I'ma put the drip on the plate. Drip, yeah, diamond ice glaze, imitate. Ice, hey, feed me grapes, maybe with the Drake. Slow pace in the rave, got this from base. Taste, taste, she can get a taste. Taste, taste, let you get a taste. Taste, taste, do you love the taste? Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me. Taste, LA, you can get a taste. Taste, Miami, you can get a taste. Taste, Oakland, you can get a taste.
So I have it on. I think I'm gonna have to trailer with it in perspective mode, versus where it's just kind of out. Seems a little more protected this way. The instructions say to try not to use zip ties. The videos that I've seen say not to use zip ties. I'm going to use zip ties. The local hardware store around here already looks at me like I'm special when I go in there, so I'm not gonna go in asking for waterproof electrical tape. Even though they probably have it like right on the front, but I'm going to use some zip ties and I'm just not going to yank down on it. I should point out also that I'm going to try and figure out how to mount my HydroWave to the trolling motor, and I'm probably going to do it at the same time. That way I'm kind of running the cables together. I'm probably going to run the cables through the brace hole here. I don't know. I think these trolling motor companies, they say they spend so much time engineering this stuff, you think they would come up with a better idea of how to run cables up the shaft. Just a thought. And as I look how it's going to line up, I'm going to put it like this, but as I, for the sake of seeing it, you know, I don't know where I'm, so I may just have to only use one, I'm thinking. I may just use one strap and put it here, and then just put the speaker like that. I've made a template out of some cardboard that fits in there. It's gonna sit down. This is what I think I'm gonna do, is figure out how to, I borrowed some wood from a neighbor, nice guy, gave me some wood for free. I'm gonna use this, and I'm gonna cut it out, and I think I'm gonna use that as the base to put this down in there. Wish me luck. I went to the hardware store. They did indeed look at me like I was crazy. Got these little furniture lock nuts, or I don't actually know what they're called, I don't remember. And then the bolts, and I had to get them a certain size so that it will all fit, and then I can get it in there. And what I'm thinking I'm gonna do is drill a hole. I pulled out a drill bit that matches the width there. I'm gonna drill a hole once I kind of mark it on there. Put these in, these kind of grab it, and then I'm going to end up taking the screw from the top and just dropping it in and tightening it. I've already kind of placed it out, mapped it out, and I can only get three. I can't reach, I'm not going to be able to reach this one, so I'm going to at least get it into three. I think that'll work, And then the next step will be figuring out how to stabilize that in there. And that's where I think the foam is going to play. So we shall see.
Get out of that mean. Taste, taste. She can get a taste. Taste, taste. She can get a taste. Taste, taste. What a new say. It's all the same like Mary Kate. Taste, taste. She can get a taste. Taste, taste. Let you get a taste. Do you love the taste? Yeah, that's cool.
How's it? Yeah, I'ma put the drip on the plate. Yeah, diamond ice glaze. Imitate, ice, ice. Ay, ay, feed me grapes, maybe with the Drake. Slow pace, in the rave, got the from base.
Taste, taste, she can get a taste. Taste, taste, let you get a taste.
Taste, taste,
do you love the taste? Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me.
Taste, taste,
LA, you can get a taste.
Taste, taste,
Miami, you can get a taste.
Taste, taste,
Oakland, you can get a taste.
Taste, taste, taste,
New York, do you love the taste?
Okay, so update, here's what I've decided to do. So I have the bass, we've talked about that. I went to the hardware store and I just have to walk around. They always ask me, what, you know, how can they help me, what I'm looking for, and I never have any idea. I just walk around until something pops out at me. I found these post brackets. These are for making, you know, posts, you know, going from concrete to wood or whatever, for deck building, I think, is what they are. Anyway, I'm going to use those. Combined with these screws that we kind of talked about before with the wood locking. This is so that I can take it out at some point. You can see I've already put it in. I kind of test it as I go. I have a very small cavity in there. And so what I'm thinking is that I'm going to put this in there and it'll push flat down the brackets. We're going to use these to mount. I'll be able to install them from inside there. And then put this over the top, kind of making it a home, and then using spray foam that will end up holding it all together. Because that was the main thing I was trying to figure out, is kind of how to protect it from bouncing around up in there. So that is where I am. That is what I'm using. And we shall press on.
Shytown, get a taste. Then you can get a taste. Hey, Portland, you can get a taste.
Taste.
Overseas, let them taste.
Taste. Taste.
Okay, I'm basically done here. The last thing I'm going to do is I found one of these little U-shaped bracket things in my garage, and I spray painted it black, and I'm going to put it here, something like this, to stop this trolling motor cable from getting up, you know, popping up into here and me trying to push down. So hopefully that'll be a little preventative step on my part. But basically I'm done. You'll notice I don't have a recessed box for the foot pedal. I don't know that I feel like messing with that right now. I'm fairly certain that it's straight foam underneath here. In other words, it's not hollow. So if I were to cut it out, I'd also have to figure out how to get the foam out. And it's just not a step I'm going to do right now. So all in all, I think it's a wrap. And now, the moment of truth, live. Oh yeah. Turns out all them chords jammed in there still works.